तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वंशा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्रिषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विग्रहे राधे तं मे मां फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम ऑफरिंग माय लैक्स एंड लैक्स ऑफ दंडक प्रणाम इन द लॉर्ड स्वीट ऑफ माय स्पिरिचुअल नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णु पाद श्री श्रीमद्भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी and also unto the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Par Shishun Bhakti Vedan Swami. We have only 4 or 5 days. So, I want to explain some essential things so that you can practice properly. And also you should know this sweet pastime of Krishna and Chaitanya. If anyone will explain thousands of years or lakhs of years, He cannot explain so much. So in 5 days, we cannot do so much. But anyhow, we will try to give something. In Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a shloka Sukhdeva Goswami told to Srila Parikshit Maharaj. When Parikshit Maharaj was going to die, at that time he asked especially 2 questions, that if a man is dying just now, in a moment, then what he should do? And if a man is going to die in a year, 2 years, 4 years, 10 years, 100 years, 1,000 years, but he must die, so what they should do? Then Sukadeva Goswami told that if anyone is going to die, at once, quickly, very quickly, then he should utter the name of Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead, at once. But if, in case, if he cannot utter Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, then a tulsi leaf with water, more better if Ganges water, not no herb. But if there is no tulsi water and Ganges water even, then you should try to give the nectar of Hare Krishna in his ear. Quickly, in a moment, in a second, he will be liberated from all the sufferings of life, birth, repeated chain of birth and life, suffering, sorrow, all the problems, quickly. Have you faith? Oh, yes. So you have all faith in Harinam? You should have faith. And quickly he was done. He did so. And if there is some much more time, then chant name and listen Harikatha. Very sweet pastimes of Krishna. Why? If a man is going to die at once, quickly, in a moment, he had no time to hear the pastimes of Krishna. Then by hearing or by chanting Krishna name, at once he will be liberated. But Krishna Premi will not come. No? Very quickly, in a moment, only hearing. He can be liberated, he can go across suffering, sorrows and so many things. But he will not have what thing? Raja Prem or Krishna. So he will have to come in next birth and to hear very past, beautiful, sweet, strong pastimes of Krishna. And then he will be liberated also, and also having such a high class of love and affection. We are not chanting name only for liberation. In world we have so much miseries and so much problems. So one month about 100% persons want this, that we should be liberated and we should have. But by her name, very quickly we can be liberated. But not love and affection will come. We have love and affection in our soul. But now it is covered with maya, illusory maya. Illusory maya, you know? This word, illusory maya. Our soul has been covered. By constitutional form, we are servant of Krishna. All. Maybe mere servant or maid servant. Anyhow, but we are not realizing all this. And in our soul, by constitution, we have love and affection. When our soul is covered with maya, our love and affection, pure, has also covered. Though it is covered, but some mane vikriti, perverted what?
Love.
In the shape of worldly lust, attachment is everywhere in all souls. But it is not real prem, not a real love and affection. When our real love and affection will develop and come, and when maya will go, and there will be no covering of maya, then pure love and affection for Krishna, supreme personality of Godhead. Because love and affection is the
embodiment
of Krishna, and also our also soul. So if a man wants to become happy forever, he should love Krishna, he should chant Krishna. Otherwise, anyhow a man cannot be happy. So once Krishna was sitting anywhere in Dwarka on the bank of sea, ocean, And he was thinking in very grave way. He thought that I have completed my pastimes in a Braja, in Mathura, in Dwarka. And I have established dharma also, religion, for which I descended. Everything has been now completed. Anyhow, strictly I should give up this place and I should go to my real abode, Golok Vrindavan, with my all associates. But he wanted that Uddha should be to this world to propagate my mission. So Uddha became so unhappy and he went to Krishna. I don't want to live alone in this world. I want to be with you. If you are in this world, I want to serve you in this world. And if you are one, you want to go to Golok Vrindavan, I want to go there and to serve. Without you, I am lifeless. I am like Jiva. Krishna told that. I am giving you something. This teachings. And you should follow. And this message should be given to all the persons, especially Kali Yuga is coming. All will be so much absorbed in sense gratification. All will take wine. They will take fleshes, beefs, so much wine, always
intoxications,
and also lust. And they will be always suffering and problems. Animal not be happy, all quarreling, not only from hands, from atom bombs, nitrogen and so many bombs. So, I want that you should be here and after some time you may come. He told that, Labdhva sudurlabham idam bahusam bhavan manushyam arthadam anityam api hathira turnam jatetana patet anumrityu yavat nisheshaya visha khalu sarvatasya. Very important slok in Srimad Bhagavatam. For beginners, it is so powerful. And we should try to obey this. And if you are not obeying this slok, then we cannot be happy. So what is this slok? Labdhva sudurlabham idam. What is the meaning, Prabhu?
Labdhva sudurlabham idam bahu sambhavante. That this human form of life, it's lavasudurva. That it is very, very rare to achieve the human form of life.
Here patiently to follow all these things. Go on.
That we go through so many different species of life, 8,400,000 species of life. But one who is very fortunate, then they achieve the human form of life. Lavasudurva idam bahusam. Manusam atadam anityam apihadira. That it is atadam. It is rare. And it is anityam, it's very, very temporary. That at any moment, then we can live our life. Just like here we see in Maui, very, very nice situation, very comfortable, heavenly. Somewhere like this I've never seen in my life. But at any moment, we can just leave. But the trick of Maya is that we get sucked into the mood of enjoying within this material world. And we forget that the real essence of the human form of life is that we should achieve God realization. So it says, Tanam yate tanapatet anumritu yadvat nishaya saya vishaya savatat kalu.
Sa.
That now in the human form of life, that immediately that one should take, before one leaves this body, that one should take to the path of self realization. Similar verses there.
Why?
Why? Because just as Prahlad Maharaj he was speaking to his friends, and they said, oh, Prahlad, it is so good that you say to take to self-realization now, but we're young, we have energy, so while we're young, we can enjoy. But Prahlad Maharaj says, no, but we do not know when we will die, that we may die at any moment. So while one is young, rather than putting off for tomorrow what one should do today, one should do that today. And what one should do today, one should not wait, one should do it right now. Just like I was just in the hotel, one man said, one should live for the moment. So this verse is saying the same thing. So right now, the moment is that we should take to the path of Bhagavad Dhamma, self-realization. Because to get this human form, bury it. And if we lose it, then we don't know what will be the destination. So when one has this opportunity, one should take chance, especially if one has opportunity to associate with devotees. Then one should always take that opportunity, especially to associate with very high-class devotees. This is really sadhu sangha. Then this is the most rare and most important thing. More rare than human form is to get this sadhu sangha.
So, Sukadeva Goswami is telling that human life we have after long births, and after this we will, whether we will have this human body or not, no certainty. And only in this form, human form, we can achieve this intelligence that we should serve Krishna in any good association. There are crocodiles, fishes, elephants, hogs, pigs, dogs. They cannot be associated. Never. They will not hear all this. Also the persons like dogs and donkeys, they will not hear. Only very fortunate person will hear all this and try to follow. And we have been sometimes snakes, donkeys, hawks, pigs in our previous births. Sometimes we have demigods, sometimes angels, sometimes so many things. When this world was created, first we were there, and so much jokes and everything has been gone. And we are same here. So if we will lose this time again for long time, lakhs and lakhs births will pass on. So be very, he is telling that jatet na patet anumittu javat, that no certainty than when we will die. It may be sometime, it may be that just we are sitting and heart fell. Then, so very quickly, don't wait for tomorrow. What you want to do tomorrow, today. And what you want to do today, you should just today, just now. We are seeing that we are going in this aeroplane, and at once it may be that quickly we all this place. We cannot come to return, we will not return to say that what happened there. So at once you should try to realize who are you. If you are coming in the process of chanting, hearing Hari Katha, and to realize which is Atma, but it is not matured and not completed, even if you die, no harm. Because you think that how we can give up all the enjoyments, sense gratification, or If you are dying just now, you will have in your other births everything, sense gratification, more than this time. If you will be hog, there will be no any rules and regulation. You can have not only one wife. At a time you can be 100 and thousand of wives and thousand of
kids.
And in this life, there is a record of in what book?
Guinness book.
That anyone changed their husbands and wife 40 or 50 times. But in that pig and hogs and dogs, in that life, you can change minute, everything. No harm. In this human life, you have only one children, or two or four, not more than 10 or 20. Not more than that. You can have at a time two, not more than that. Three, have you heard?
Yes.
Oh, three.
My grandfather,
50
children.
No, at a time. Four. But dogs and fish, they can have 16 and more than that.
Seven. Record is seven. At what time?
Achha. But dogs and bitch and all other, they can have 50 tortoise at a time. 100, 1,000. So we will not lose nothing. So in this human body, try to realize yourself. You are not this body. So everything is there reserved for us if you are going again in any birth. You can enjoy there sense gratification. But here, let you chant and remember how we can realize this. So, we can come, you can come with me. Coming in India, no passport and visa is needed. Come only with me, quickly. And we are going to India. Where? In Triveni, Prayag. Prayag, you know, where Ganga, Jamuna and Saraswati are meeting together. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu from Nilachal, Puri. He has gone to Vrindavan. Always weeping, O Krishna, O Krishna, where you are, where you are. Ask him from trees and creepers, and deers also. Oh, Krishna used to, Kanaiya used to love you. Where he is now? Where he is now? Without him, I will die yet. So weeping, water coming from eyes like Ganges and Jamunas. Sometimes he used to be faint, rolling down the earth. After this, he returned anyhow. And he was at that time on the bank of Ganges, Prayag. And he was returning to Nilachal. And in the meantime, Rupa Goswami with his one brother, younger brother, Anubhav, he quickly left out, the king's very high class of service position. He was private secretary of Hussain Shah, king. He was so much rich, but not happy. He wanted that I should join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. His brother Sanatan, elder brother, also wanted. Anyhow, Rupa Goswami was being so learned, having so much affluence, so much power. But quickly he left the kingdom and that service. And he took what he has collected money in a boat and he went to his home. And half of that money he distributed to devotees and Brahmins. And again, half of the half,
one-fourth,
that is one-fourth, he gave for household affairs. Because Jiva Goswami was at that time very little boy, so he should be supported, and that is why he gave all this money to them. And he kept some money for Sanatana Goswami, that he is in jail. Anyhow, by this money, anyhow giving some greed to authorities, and he should come out of jail and join. Now he has nothing, one pence or farthing in his pocket. If you want to realize all these things, you will have to come in the path of Rupa Goswami. Nothing in pocket, because it may be that by money some false ego may come, and then you will rely on that money, not on Krishna mercy. So this, that is not process, but process is what? If anything you have, you should distribute among those who want this. And be akinchan and niskinchan. No any requirement worldly, nothing. And then come, how Rupa Goswami came, Sanatana Goswami came. So, giving everything, and he went to, he was coming to Vrindavan to see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But in the way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in Prayag, and he met in Prayag. He heard that a very beautiful young Bengali Juvak. Bengali, young, very beautiful, sannyasi, renounce order, age about 24. And he sings so much and dance, telling Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari
Bol.
And always weeping, weeping, weeping. So lakhs of persons always surrounding him. So, quickly, Rupa Goswami with his brother went to the bank of Ganges and Yamuna, Triveni, and he saw that lakhs of devotees are there, and a very beautiful young sannyasi, like Bal Sannyasi. Bal Sannyasi? Young sannyasi. He is weeping and bitterly crying, "Oh Krishna, oh Krishna. Govinda Damo
Dharmaya Vedi, Govinda Damo Dharmaya Vedi, Govinda Damo Dharmaya Vedi, Govinda Damo Dharmaya Vedi."
Always the thing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. All they are attracted. Rupa Goswami was seeing for very long, very far
distance.
And he quickly did Dandavat Pranam, Sastang Dandavat Pranam. And he also began to be. After that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to the house of Brahmin devotees. And quickly Rupa Goswami went there. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw Rupa Goswami, at once he became so happy and impressed. Oh, Krishna is so merciful. to take you out of what?
Deep well.
Of stool. Stool and urine. You are so lucky to come. And then Rupa Goswami began to pray. There's so many slopes. Oh, I'm so low, insignificant, so much wretched person. Now I'm like a Muslim because I've lost my all Vedic and culture and everything. So I'm not like a Hindu now. Don't touch me, otherwise you will be also impure. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu began to tell me that if a Brahmin is there but not chanting and remembering Krishna, he is so wretched and fallen soul. But you are chanting and remembering Krishna always. You are not a Muslim or Hindu or anything. You are very near and dear to me. And he is Krishna. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami asked him that I'm so wretched, nonsense, you should be merciful and give me some instruction that I can follow and I can serve eternally you. Then he told, began to tell, oh, the ocean of love and affection is so deep and endless. I'm telling only some one drop. I cannot tell all. Only I can sprinkle a drop of that love and affection. And he began to tell. I'm going to tell the same thing to you. He began to tell that you should think that this body is like a cloth. You are saying it is very beautiful, charming, sweet. But if anyone can take this skin from here only, then what? No beauty will be there. If anyone will see in his stomach anywhere, if anyone going to open this, then what is there? Only rotten, what? Stool, very bad smelling, what things? Also nonsense things here. And then a beautiful princess, and if you will do like that, and if something white here, anyone cannot marry you. So you are not this body. First you should try to know. You will have to give up. If you are not vacating this, then Jamdut will come, the messenger will come. At once they will kick you out from this house. One day you will have to vacate it. So, he is telling that we should try to realize this thing. Oh, if I will give, I am giving whole energy to realize these things that I am so, then how I will manage my life, maintaining my life? Don't be worried, don't worry. In this world, all wants happiness. All wants happiness. No one wants
suffering and sorrow.
Any of you You want suffering in life? Anyone? We take wine. Why? To forget our troubles, problems. We go to sea, take bath. We marry. We do any job. We murder anyone. Why? Only that we will be happy. So everyone wants happy. But it is sure that whether Krishna or God is there or not. But one thing is true. What that?
Death is sure.
Death is sure. And we are seeing daily, so many. And also one thing is also true. What? Sufferings in this life. Without any labor, without any endeavor, power, quickly suffering will come. Death will come. Now you are so happy and so beautiful, but old ways will come and take all beauties. So it is true. So if you are not doing anything for sufferings, but sufferings are coming, troubles are coming, and we'll have to enjoy that. So if there is happiness, anything, it will come automatic. Not doing any endeavor or labor for that. If sufferings are coming automatic, happiness also will come automatic. So don't be worried for that. Try to chant and remember that, you know, for eternal you can be happy. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first telling that Keshagra Satabhagasya Sraddha Kalpitasya Cha Bhago Jiva Sabhigya Sachanantaya Kalpitasya. We are not this body. We are part and parcel of Supreme Godhead. But now it is covered with Maya, illusory Maya. And until the Maya is there covering our this soul, we will always be suffering. So many. But problems there, birth and death, endless, a chain of repeated birth and death will be there. So we are soul, very fine. If our hair will be divided into lakhs parts, and again that one part will be divided into lakhs parts, it is not possible. But even we can do if by like scientist methods now, it may be, but more fine than that, Atma is yours. So, anyhow, it has been covered with illusory Maya. And we are knowing now that we are human body. We are woman, we are man, we are male, we are female, we are trees, we are this mountain, we are rivers, we are trees, creepers, and we are all happy in that. But having so much distance and suffering also. But we are accustomed to be happy. Like, to take wine is not good. But we take wine and we fell down in a very dirty drain. And dogs may come wash our mouths. How? By hot water coming from there. And we think that, oh, we are monarch of home. But we think that we are happy. Once Indra, by any his offenses to his Gurudev, he became hog or pig. Pig. And here in this world, he has so many wives, hundreds and thousands of children. And he was here and there, making merry everywhere. Sometimes in rain, sometimes taking so fresh meals. And happy. Brahma was going anywhere and he saw that Indra is in that state. Oh, Indra, why you are roaming here and there with so many sufferings, taking stools and urines, bathing in dirty drains? Oh, I am not Indra, I am what I am. I am happy with my children and wives. No, you will have to come to heaven. And there is nectar to take. And very beautiful garden, Nandan Kanan there. No death, no birth, nothing. Always young, very beautiful, teeny age. So you should come. Oh no, never. I cannot give up my children and wives. Oh, if I go, then with all my children and wives, and if there is any delicious food like here, there, always, no, there is nothing, there is only nectar. When he did not become ready, at once he took some water from his kamandalu and sprinkled. And at once he said, oh, I am so beautiful. Oh. Then he told that if you are not going alone, that I will do. And he began to kill one after another all his childs. And when he wanted to attack Brahma, he used to
go high
in his car. So thus all children he killed. And after that, oh, again there are my so many wives. Again one will give 50-50 and then again like that. No harm. I don't want to go to hell. At once he said, killed all his wives and sprinkled water on him with mantra powerful. And he realized that I must go at once. I will not delay. Then Brahma took him. So we are like all this. We are thinking that, we are very happy in Hawaii, on the coast of ocean, all beautiful mountains, so many fruits, so many trees, creepers, and we are happy. But happy for how many minutes? You'll have to give up. You have to vacate this Hawaii. And where you'll go, no one. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling to Rupa Goswami, in this world, tar madhye sthavar jangam dui bhed, jangam trijak jale jalachara bhed. There are numerous, endless jivas, souls in this world. So many. We cannot count. Can you count how many we are here? How many? Oh yes, not more than 100, about 50, 55 are like this. But if you will take one drop of blood from here, and we will see in any powerful glass, microscope, then we will see that endless, numberless, so many, like worms. They are all souls, grasses, all the grasses are souls, all the trees, in trees so many fruits, and in fruits so many seeds, all has separate of souls. we cannot count. Even in a drop, how many souls are there, we cannot count. But they are divided into two. What? Sthavar and Jangam. What? Sthavar Jangam?
Moving and non-moving.
Moving and non. What is moving? We are moving. Animals can move. Birds can move. They are like that. And one, like trees, creepers, mountains, they cannot move. So, two kinds of the souls. And in them, Tirja, Jalachar, Sthalachar, so many kinds of. We have seen that only fishes, once we went to
Singapore,
and a museum,
Santosa Island,
Aquarium.
And we saw lakhs and lakhs kinds of fishes, lakhs and lakhs, only fishes, what to tell, crocodiles, tortoises and so many, snakes, ghoda, ghoda means
horse,
water horse.
Sea horses,
so many. And in this land, who are moving here and there, lakhs kinds of bird, lakhs kinds of human, not human. In this form only one, lakhs and lakhs kinds of humans are in this world. So, in that, we are one of them. In that, the supreme humans are like those who are following Varnashram Dharma, knowing Vedic culture, having so much mercy to all. They don't eat flesh, don't wine, never intoxications and cigarette and all other things. Like, I have not taken any of this in my whole life from birth. So these are somewhat more
advanced.
In them, if they are not chanting and remembering, not remembering, their life is useless. So in those who are following Vedic culture, having so much mercy to all, not taking flesh and wine and all other things, in them some are like Bauddha, some like Jaina. What is Bauddha? World has come from zero and again it will be zero. Still he is like zero. Everything is false, nothing. But this is wrong idea. There are so many Jaina, there are so many others. Some are that they believe in God, but by mouth only, not by their actions. They know that God is everywhere. God means G, generator, O, operator, D,
destroyer.
But we don't believe, only believe by mouth. He is controller of the whole world. He has created this world. He is nourishing this world. And he is so merciful. We tell like mouth, but don't believe in that. Otherwise, we have served him. We don't want his mercy. We want that we can know how to make bomb, how to control others. They don't believe that he controls all. Then never. So they don't believe in that God. Only by mouth only. In them, there are so many karmi, satkarmi. Satkarmi, you know? What is satkarmi? Doing pious activities.
Mode of goodness.
People in mode of goodness. Satoguni love.
Pious activities. And in them, Gyanis are more superior. Gyani means, oh, I am not this body. We are so. And by Gyan, knowledge, we can be renounced from this world and liberated, and we can become one in God. There are so many. And in them, very rare are Krishna Bhakta. Very rare. In Krishna Bhakta, Praja Bhakta are very rare. And in them, Dasya is very rare. In that, Sakya is so rare. In Sakya, lakhs and lakhs Sakya, one Vatsalya, like Yashoda Maiya and Nanda Baba, very rare. And in lakhs and lakhs, Vatsalya mode, very rare is Brajbhav, like gopis. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him that this is the object. The love in them, in Brajavasi, like Yashoda Maiya, more than that in gopis. The love for Krishna is highest, supreme. This is our object. But how to attain this? Very easy, very easy. But we don't want to follow. So we will explain it in tomorrow class. Gaur Pranam.
Hari Hari Gaur. Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj ki jai. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe Radhe, Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe
Radhe, Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe Radhe, Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe.
Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama,